The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even mine enemies and my foes, come upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumble and fell. Though an host shall encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war shall rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desire of the Lord, hallelujah, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. Psalms 27, 1, 3, 4. Good morning to you trumpeters and prayer partners. This is your host of Morning Devotions, Evangelist Brian Bassett. Coming to you this morning with a word to encourage you, to bless you, to lift you up, to strengthen you, and to bring you always closer to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The title of this word this morning is simply, What is the desire of God for me? What is God's desire for me? My desire should be God's desire, and God's desire should be my desire. Once I have decided to accept Jesus Christ as my personal Savior and give him my life and say, Lord, I surrender all to you, I no longer have a desire. I no longer have my own will to do the things that I want to do. It's no longer about me anymore. It's all about him. And who is him? The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I like to say the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. The one who lives in me, the one who dwells in this world today, and the one whom Jesus said, I will ask the Father to send in my place. He said, I will not leave you comfortless. We are not alone, child of God. The Holy Spirit lives on the inside of us. He dwells on the inside of us. And if it had not been for the Holy Spirit in this particular world that we are living in today, there would be so much chaos and pandemonium and crime and everything that the devil would unleash. But thank God the power of the Holy Ghost is dwelling in this earth. But one day God is going to remove and pull out the Holy Ghost. And this world is going to be without any type of covering, spiritual covering. Hallelujah. And that day is when you and I, who believe in the resurrection, who believe in the Son of God, who believe in the power of God, who believe that God sent his Son into the world to die for you and I, who believe in the rapture, amen, we will be taken out of this world and we will be caught up to meet Jesus in the air. I'm believing and I'm receiving that, and I can't wait for it to happen. And I pray every day, God, help my life to be a light to shine among this world in darkness, that men may see the works that you are doing in my life. Let my desire be your desire. God, change all of my desires, everything that I have about Brian Bassett. Hallelujah. Father, take it away. Move it, Lord God. That which is not of you, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that you would extract it and that you would eliminate it and that you would nail it to the cross. Hallelujah. And that you would wash me thoroughly. Hallelujah. And cleanse me from all unrighteousness, that I may be a beacon, hallelujah, in this world, that wherever I go, people will see and they will know that I have been hanging out with Jesus Christ, and they will know and they will say it. There is something about you that's just glowing. There's a light upon your face that's glowing. Can you tell me what it is? Hallelujah. And I would say it is the presence of God. It is the glory, hallelujah, of God. God's desire for you and I to live a life, hallelujah, a victorious life, a life of prosperity, a life that you and I don't have to look to the world, amen. That is His desire. His desire is for us to serve Him, to worship Him, to look to Him, amen, hallelujah. I love what John said here in Little John. We call him Little John, amen, which is the third John, hallelujah, amen, hallelujah, chapter 1, praise the name of the Lord. And let's look at verse number 2, amen, 3rd John chapter 1 and verse 2. It says, Beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper. That's what God wants you to do. God wants you to prosper. God don't want you to be broke, busted, disgusted, and not to be trusted. Amen. God wants you and me to be prosper. Amen. He said, Beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in good health. God wants you to be in good health. He doesn't want you to be sick. He doesn't want you to be running around with Alzheimer's and all kinds of sickness and cancer and all of these things. He said, even as thy soul prosper. He said, not just your body. He said, I want your body to prosper, but I want your soul to prosper even more, because your body eventually is going to decay and die, but your soul is going to live on. Amen. We are not living and praising God for an everlasting body in this world. We are living and praising God for an everlasting celestial body. Amen. That our souls will prosper and live eternally with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and to worship Him. Amen. And to be around the throne of God. Hallelujah. With all the host of angels and all the people who have accepted Him as their personal Savior, and to live with Him for eternity, and to worship Him, hallelujah, and to see Him as He is. Amen. God wants you to prosper. So I speak prosperity over you, over your body. I speak healing over your body in the name of Jesus Christ right now. Be healed, be delivered, be set free, hallelujah, from all of those things that the enemy is trying to attack your body with right now in the name of Jesus. I love what the Bible says here in Psalms 121. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's read Psalms 122. Amen. Psalms 122, and it says here, hallelujah, in first verses, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Amen. Our feet shall stand within the gates of Jerusalem. Oh, Jerusalem. Hallelujah. Pray for Jerusalem. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Pray for victory, hallelujah, for Jerusalem over the wicked Hamas and all of those enemies that are seeking to eliminate Jerusalem, amen, who is trying to eliminate Israel. Pray for the peace of Israel. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Pray, hallelujah, that Jerusalem's enemies will be eliminated, even as the scripture said, let God arise and His enemies be scattered. And I like to say splattered. Amen. And that's what's going to happen to Hamas and everyone else who come against Israel. God will deliver Israel out of their hands. Hallelujah. And God will stand up. He will continue to fight. Amen. And stand with Israel. And because I stand with Israel, and because I stand for God, I stand for His word, I stand for all of His word. Amen. And I stand with Israel. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ. And so therefore, I said, I was glad, and my desire is God's desire. Whatever He desired today, it is my desire, hallelujah, to worship Him, to serve Him, and to be with Him and to preach His gospel. One thing have I desire of the Lord, amen, and that is to seek after Him. Amen. Nothing else. Everything that He has blessed me with, I thank Him for it. Amen. And as long as I am seeking and you are seeking his desire, child of God, he is going to bless you. You will be blessed. You will be healed. You will be delivered. You will have victory. The enemy will not have victory over you. Even though he come against you like a flood, God will always lift up a standard, hallelujah, for you to walk in victory. This is my desire, hallelujah. I don't know about you, but my desire is to walk and to talk with Jesus Christ and to have fellowship with him. Let's be blessed. Listen to this song.
Let me know.
note, if this word has been a blessing to you, will you send me back an encouraging word? Hallelujah. And say, Lord, I give you my heart right now in the name of Jesus. Come on, lift your hands up and sing it. Oh, yeah. Every breath that I take, every moment I'm awake, Lord, have your way in me. As always, if this word has been a blessing to you, will you say, Brother Bassett, I want to encourage you as well. Pray for us as we embark on our way to Africa, Cameroon, Africa. We need your prayers. We need your support. We need you to be standing in prayer for us. Amen. Hallelujah. Lift us up in prayer. And that God will give us the victory over the enemy in the name of Jesus Christ. Remember, you don't have any trouble. All you need is faith in God. Be blessed. Be encouraged. Be strong in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Like me on social media. My website, YouTube, and all of that good stuff. God bless you today. Be encouraged. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Bye-bye.